Hey guys, Dan with Plowz Mowz here. Got something a little different for you. We're headed to the GIE, which is a Garden Industry Expo in Louisville, Kentucky. It's probably the largest, if you're in the green industry, it's the largest event that happens in the United States for our industry. Everything from technology, which is us, to gear and you know, even personalities in the lawn care industry are there. Basically, we're going down to accomplish a couple things, shake hands with the, you know, our landscapers, meet new landscapers, and try to keep up on technology and gear. So we're going to be down there. We thought we'd start a little video vlog. We'll put it all together towards the end to kind of give you kind of a full scope of, you know, first day, second day, third day, some of the stuff that we thought is cool. Just in case some of you can't make it out. If you can't make it out, that's what the internet's for. We can do some cool stuff and shoot it out to you. I know we're going to put it up in our news board. This may go out to YouTube. And if it does, you can share that content with any of your buddies. But other than that, stay tuned. Got some pretty cool stuff. Got the crew here. Dan, Allison, and Ty in the back. We're going to be doing an iPad giveaway and just giving out a bunch of stuff while we're there. You know, obviously you guys know, pick up a swag bag when you're there.
Come say hi.
Come say hi, booth 571. You'll probably see this after. Now that I'm thinking about it.
Yeah.
But it's something that we're going to be doing every year. So stick around. How's it going? Just wanted to do a quick little video, which we're going to edit in, which is going to be, good Lord, son, how long it's going to take for me to walk to or from one side of the GIE to the other. We're going to start here at Hardscapes. It's going to go down a little bit, and then we're going to take a right, and we're going to walk to the other side of the Expo Center. I think if I was to do it normally, it would take about 25 minutes to walk from one side to the other. We're going to speed it up a little bit, but I kind of want to give you guys and gals a visual of how big this place actually is. Alright, so as you can see, I've just done one little loop. Basically, let's go behind here. All the way down where the lights ended, that's like the north wing, kind of where it starts. Now we're going to head in that direction where the light trail ends in a point. That should take me about 5-10 minutes to walk through. So we'll take a look at all that stuff, and that's coming up right now. So that gives you a basic rundown of the length of the place. It's gigantic, and we only did one row. If you come down and this is something that you want to see, I would suggest 2-day stay to kind of run through all of this. So Tyler's rocking some tunes. So we're headed out. This is at the end of the show. Usually what we do is everyone's heading out to 4th Street. So people are packing up. Day two starts at 9, ends at 5, and we're headed to 4th Street. That's what everyone does here, so we're gonna do that for a little bit. Meet up with some people, landscapers, have some drinks, and eat some food. Maybe we'll shoot some video when we're down there just to show you what it's like. Good morning, last day at the GIE. I'm gonna head over to Boss to kind of show you guys some new tech. So stick around, say hi to the crew.
Hey guys, holding it down.
And then this is also our neighbor,
Pat Butler.
Do you want to give them a little quick of what you do?
Yeah, Pat Butler does residential and commercial pet waste removal. So we work with people that are in the green industry to add a line of service like Pat Butler to what they already do.
All right. I'd be interested in that too.
Mark, what's happening?
Danny, how you doing, man?
Good, good, bud. So I just want to introduce everyone to Mark. Mark here is the VP over at Boss.
Yeah, I think one of the things that everyone at Plowz and Mowz doing driveways would really like to see is our back drag plow, the
cool.
Drag Pro.
Let's
walk back, take a look at it. So, as the name implies, the Drag Pro actually goes on the back end of a pickup truck instead of the front end like most people are used to with snow plows. So the beautiful thing about a back drag plow is you can keep the plow on the front and add a plow onto the back. The thing that's unique about a back drag plow, in the case of our Drag Pro 8-16, is that it folds out to 16 feet wide. So you go down the road and the two wings on the side will fold in so you're only 8 feet wide, but then you can back up to a garage door in a driveway and hydraulically wing the wings out to match the width of the driveway. Drop it down, put down pressure on it, pull forward, and literally clear the entire driveway with one pass. Pull right out to the street, then you turn around and push the snow up into the bank on the side off the curb, and away you go. So it's a great productivity increaser, and a lot of the guys that run back drag plows that do driveways say it literally cuts their time in half doing a driveway. So if you think about that, during an event, you could literally cover twice as many jobs in the same amount of time. Obviously, then you're gonna make more money doing that. So it's a great, great tool. This is the Drag Pro. We actually make it in an 8-16 and an 8-12 foot model. And we actually have a static 8 foot wide model too that does not wing out.
Guys, if you have any questions, reach out. Anyone on the biz dev team, anyone in the office, most of you have my cell. If you don't, you can find it.
Yeah, we appreciate it. And again, if you have any more questions of us or the folks at Plowz and Mowz, feel free to reach out. And like Danny said, we have plenty of video of this thing running on bossplow.com. So if you want to see it in action, kind of understand how it works, reach out to us or go to our website and you'll have plenty of video to choose from.
So that was the back drag. Very nice of Mark to give us a moment of his time. As you can see, it's starting to pick up here. It's pretty busy. But I do think that the back drag could really help out take your business to the next level. It's all about efficiency. How can I get more jobs done quicker, faster? And I think the back drag is a good introduction to increasing a portion of the business, which is efficiency and time. So I forgot to mention this, and if I did, well, I forgot to mention it. There's an outside area to demo gear. I'm gonna do a quick walkthrough. It's not gonna be quick, it's pretty big. I want to walk over this way to introduce you to one of the booths that is here. We've walked past them on a daily basis, maybe 30, 40 times a day. And we've listened to a couple of their conversations. And I think they are pretty cool. It's called Project Evergreen. Nikki is a person that's going to be speaking real quick, but I would like to at least introduce you to these people. I think what they're doing is pretty solid and necessary. I just stopped here, so I'm going to flip the camera around, and I'll be with you in just a minute.
Thanks, Dan. My name is Nikki. I am one of the program managers for Project Evergreen's Green Care for Troops and Snow Care for Troops. And we are a nonprofit. We are nationwide. And what we do is we match volunteers that will help take care of lawns and or provide snow removal services to military families that have a loved one that is deployed. And when they are matched with a military family, we do ask that they take care of the military family for the length of the deployment. If something were to change and they couldn't, we ask that the volunteers contact us. This way we can help find another volunteer to take care of the military families, because we don't want to leave them without lawn care service and or snow removal services. And we've been growing. We're here today at GIE 2019 recruiting volunteers for our program.
All right, guys, that was the photo.